Okay, let us begin with few more theorems today. Theorem, let M belong to R, consider the point A, x0, y0. Then there exists one line U. Passing through a and having slope M. Now, I mean, this is obvious theorem. We have used this theorem assuming that it is true and solved problems. Basically, it says if we have a point and if you have been given some slope, then there exists a unique line passing through, exactly one line passing through that point having that slope. So exists and exactly one. So existence and uniqueness, both. So it is relatively easy. I give you a couple of few minutes to write a complete correct proof of this. And I will not check it. I will write my proof. You can rewrite my proof in your notebook. Wait for a few minutes. Resume recording. Proof. So it's a two things that we are supposed to prove exist and exactly one. So let us prove it in two parts. Consider a point B. Now we know slope of a line is distance traveled in positive direction of y-axis per unit distance traveled in positive direction of x-axis. That is what we have defined as slope, which is given to be m, so m upon 1. So consider a point B, which is x0 plus 1 comma y0 plus m, right? Therefore, slope of AB is, slope of AB is y2 minus y1, y0 plus m minus y0 divided by x0 plus 1 minus x0, which is equal to m, right? So AB, so slope of maybe line AB is M, hence AB is such a line. Such a line means a line, it's a line with slope M passing through A, x0, y0, right? So now what we do is, suppose u be any other line, let u be any other line, u be any other line passing through A, having slope M. As M is available, U is not parallel to y-axis. Correct? Therefore, you must intersect given line. You must intersect given line at x0 plus 1 comma y1. We don't know what that point is. So if we take another point x0 plus 1, x coordinate of that point x0 plus 1, then suppose you intersect the given line at this point P, then slope of AP is equal to y1 minus y0, that is A upon x0 plus 1 minus x0, which is equal to y1 minus y0, which is equal to given m. This implies y1 is equal to y0 plus m, implies P coincides B. Hence, unique. Okay, so that is what is the systematic proof of what we have said and used earlier, that there exists unique line, one exactly one line passing through point A having given slope M. Now, if there exists, now this should have been done much earlier, but now we are doing it because we did not have time at that time. So then it is interesting to find out what is the equation of this line. Hence, find the equation of U. Okay, U. Now you will say, oh sir, we know equation of U is equal to mx or maybe y minus y0 is equal to m into x minus x0. That is what you will say, but this is what we have assumed, and maybe algebraically we have said, we have proved it also using slope etc., but that is what precisely which we are doing right now. If there exists a unique line passing through A having slope m, how do we get the equation of that line? I wait for a couple of minutes. There is a small problem. We will address that after this pause. If I want to find out the equation of line U, I will use locus method. And locus method says, let U belong to required locus S. Let P x dash comma y dash belong to required locus S, and this equation of this S that we are trying to find out, which happens to be the straight line. Okay. What is the geometric condition? Geometric condition is slope of AP is equal to M. This is our geometric condition, right? There is one catch, if possible. Let find the equation of U, and what is the condition on U? Passes through A x0 comma y0 having slope M. Okay. So if possible, let. Now, what is the problem here? What is the problem here? Slope of AP is equal to M. That is what I am writing. But unfortunately, if y dash is equal to y zero, then we will be in trouble, because the moment I want to write, what is the next step from here? I would like to write down the slope. What do I mean by slope? Slope of AP. Slope of AP is y dash minus y zero upon x dash minus x zero. Sorry. So if x dash is equal to x zero, x coordinate of A and P, if they are same, then I am in trouble, right? So if possible, let x dash is not equal to x zero. Then if x dash is not equal to x zero, then what will happen? Y dash minus y zero upon x dash minus x zero is equal to M. So if x dash is not equal to x zero, indirectly what I am trying to say is P is not A. If P becomes A, then both of them will become 0 and 0, 0 upon 0, and then trouble. Do you understand the trouble? Because for you to find out slope, you need two distinct points. And therefore, let P x dash comma, or I can say like this, let P x dash comma y dash belong to S, and P is not A, then I need not have to write this if possible, etc. I mentioned P is not A, therefore this statement is legal, and therefore if the simple algebra y dash minus y zero is equal to M into x dash minus x zero, replacing y dash by y and x dash by x, we get desired equation of line. Y minus y zero is equal to M into x minus x zero. Okay. But now P is not on A. When you develop this equation, you develop the equation of line without A. Understand this. So using this procedure, whatever we have developed is the line geometrically. Let me explain you this, very important, and I will be referring to this many times in future. This is A and it is hollow. This is A and it is a hollow circle. That means I am going to let P be any point x dash comma y dash on desired line. But can P be A? No, not allowed. P is not A. So as far as writing the proof is concerned, I am excluding A from the proof. So infinitely many points are under consideration, but except A. So the equation that I have developed, this equation I have developed, which is of this line, we call this as punctured line. Line is punctured at one point. Oh, but we did not want that to happen. Therefore, what we do is, now let us see whether A belongs to that. Now, having got this equation, y minus y zero is equal to M into x minus x zero, let us check whether A x naught comma y naught belongs to this line or not, belongs to this line or not. And if we are okay, let us check, put y is equal to y zero minus y zero is equal to zero, which is equal to M into x zero minus x zero, which is equal to zero. Yes, A satisfies this line. And therefore, we have developed an equation of punctured line, and then we cross check whether A satisfies that or not. And we found that he satisfies it, therefore it is equation of life. Hey, therefore, y minus y zero is equal to m into x minus x zero is complete, is equation of complete life. Okay, now this is again if and only if type of proof. If any point satisfies this equation, it belongs to the line locus, and if any point you take from line, it satisfies this equation. If and only if type, we have done many times that if and only if business. But very important, punctured line. I will refer to this word punctured line many times in learning other concepts up to 12th standard. Punctured line, and this is a very good bypass. Otherwise, we are stuck. You will not be allowed to write the equation of slope of AP, because immediately the question will come: are you allowed to write this ratio? You don't know whether x dash is x zero or not. The moment x dash becomes x zero, you are not supposed to write it in the denominator. And therefore, equating slope to that, this step is first step itself is going to be illegal. And therefore, we had to start with p not equal to a. P does not coincide a. Very important. But then, what is great? Eventually, we got the equation, and a satisfies that equation. Therefore, whatever puncture was there is removed. Okay. I hope you have understood. Okay. Next theorem. If two distinct lines in XY plane have equal slopes, then they are parallel. Of course, we have again used this theorem many times, but it is time to write technically correct proof. Proof. This is easy. All of you can write. I give you sufficient time. Let U1 and U2 be two lines distinct . Let slope of U1 equals slope of U2. If possible, let U1 intersect U2 is not empty. Let A x0, y0 belong to U1 intersection U2. Hence, two distinct lines having slope equal pass through A, x0, y0, contradiction previously proved here. Easy. Okay, maybe. Next theorem. If two lines in XY plane are parallel, then either one, they both are parallel to y axis, or two, their slopes are equal. Okay, proof. Proof after 4 minutes. Proof. Let U1 A1x plus B1y plus C1 is equal to 0, and U2 A2x plus B2y plus C2 is equal to 0. B2 lines. Such that U1 parallel U2. Case 1. U1 parallel y-axis and U1 parallel U2 implies case 2. U1 is not parallel to y-x. Proved. Here it is proved. Both the lines are parallel, then either they are both. This first part is proved. Now second part, U1 is not parallel to y-axis. Now this implies B is not equal to 0. Now let me explain you this. Now this is going to be very interesting and important discussion. Pay attention. I have xy axis. And suppose there is a point here through which I have a line. Okay. Now definitely this particular line has a positive slope and it has got some intersections. Let intersection of x-axis be called capital A and intersection of y-axis be called capital B. Now I am fixing this point. I start rotating this line like this around P, point P. So what will happen is after some time this line will become like this. Still it has got a positive slope. Y axis intersect B has become positive. And x-axis intercept A has gone towards left. Earlier it was here, now it is there. Suppose I further move it this side. What is going to happen? Y-axis intersect is again going to go up and A will go far away like this. Do you realize this? This is the dynamic situation of the line I am explaining. So if you consider x-axis intercept, now let the equation of line be AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. And therefore the slope is minus A by B. And now I am reducing the slope. Earlier this slope is minus A by B. Now I am reducing the slope and making it almost in the limiting case. I am going to make this line horizontal, passing through P. So at that time the slope is going to be 0. So slope is minus A by B. Presently it is positive, positive slope. Therefore the equation of maybe this line we can consider as 2x plus 3y plus something C is equal to 0. It is the original first position of this line, right? And the slope is minus, So slope here is going to be 2 by 3. Okay, so it is a positive slope. Now, as I keep, or let me write it like this, 2x minus 3y is equal to, instead of x naught, y naught, let me write down the point also. P is say, it is 2 comma 1. So equation of original line was 1. 2x minus 3y is equal to 1. Then I reduce the slope. What am I doing when I am reducing the slope? I am reducing the slope if I am keeping A fixed, then I am increasing B, or if I am keeping B fixed, then I am increasing A. So let me keep A fixed. So 2x y is equal to something. So what should I write now? When here it was minus 3, slope was 2 by 3 and I want to reduce the slope. Suppose I want to make slope 1 by 3 now. Suppose the slope has to be made 1 by 3, I must write minus 6 here. Do you realize that? Minus 6. Now the slope is 1 by, how much? 1 by 3. Now earlier it was 2 by 3, now it is 1 by 3. So I have reduced it. And if it is passing through 2 comma 1, then it is 4 minus 6 is minus 2. Okay? This is very important. So you understand this. Now I am further reducing the slope. Let me reduce the slope further. I will write complete that proof later on, but let me explain you this dynamic situation. Suppose I want to, so if I put 2x minus 100y, then what is the slope? 1 by 50. It is positive, but very, very less, is equal to something. 2 minus 2x minus 10,000y is equal to. Oh, slope is still positive, but very close to 0, because it is, suppose it is 2x, this, so 1 upon 10,000, so it is 5,000. That is the slope of this line, new line that we'll draw. So you understand when I am reducing this number, the line is becoming parallel and parallel, therefore this quantity B, if your A is positive, then B is tending to minus infinity. B is tending to minus infinity. The line becomes horizontal and therefore this is very large compared to this, and hence this is A is very small, and minus BY, or what am I trying to say, is this number is negatively signed, and B per se, absolute value of B is going to be very large number, and therefore eventually the equation of horizontal line, dotted horizontal line passing through 2 comma 1 will become what? what will be the eventual equation of this line, green line, horizontal line that I have drawn? Y is equal to 1. What does it mean? When I say y is equal to 1 is the equation of this line which I will get by this dynamic situation, that means this coefficient b is negative. If a is positive, b is negative, negatively signed, and it is a too large number compared to a. So for all practical purposes, you consider a to be 0, because in this case also 2x minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 y is equal to, what will be RHS? RHS is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 into 1. So this is negatively signed. And then plus 4. Right? So I think it is very difficult to subtract also, but 6, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9. So this number is practically equal to this number with negative sign. And this is still finite, and I can write it. If I keep making this number very, 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 very big, then this is not carrying any importance, and therefore eventually equation will become minus by equal to minus b, which is y is equal to 1. That is the equation of horizontal line. That means I am making this x-axis intercept go towards minus infinity. The line becomes horizontal and it starts looking like this. So for all practical purposes, the equation of this, I can write it as 0x plus 1y is equal to 1. This is the equation of line having slope minus 0 upon 1. Correct, horizontal, and y-axis intercept 1. Baga samajhte ka? Okay, good. Mala ata andaz nahi hai, tumhala samajhte ka nahi? Are ho mana, ho, dishte ata mala. Samajhle ka, this dynamic situation? Okay, so I have gone, x-axis intercept I have taken to minus infinity. Okay, now, I'm not stopping at this point. I will further rotate it. Now, the moment I tilt this way little bit, what will happen? This line will intersect where? Towards extreme positive. So now the slope is 0. Here slope was positive. Now I am making the slope. Suppose let me draw black line. Now the slope is negative. Okay. So suddenly this b is going to be positive extreme. So let me write down, say, equation 2x plus something like this, 6 times y is equal to, oh my god, what is this, 1 0 0 0 0 0 4. Do you realize this is the equation? This is too large. So by rotating it this way little bit, immediately I am jumping from x-axis intercept negative side to positive side. Okay, so, and now I can further rotate so that what will happen? This number, what will happen? Suppose I rotate it further. Then the slope is becoming, now the slope is minus 2 upon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is a minus, very small slope. But if I now start reducing this number, bringing it closer and closer, 2x plus 50y is equal to 104. Slope is 1 upon 25. And x-axis intercept, if I put y is equal to 0, x-axis intercept is 52, something like this. If I further reduce it, 2x plus 2y is equal to 4, 5, 6. Oh, 45 degree line. Y-axis intercept is 3, x-axis intercept is also 3, something like that. Is that right? No, 3 and y is equal to 0 is 3, x is equal to 0 is also 3, 45 degree. Okay. Now, I further do it this way. Now, what will happen is, suppose in limiting case, if I make it vertical. So what am I doing now? I am reducing this. But suppose now I have reached the stage 2x plus y is equal to 5. And now reducing this is writing fractions. Therefore, I increase this. So 100x plus y is equal to 201. What is the slope of this line? What is the slope of minus 100? Minus 100 is very steep. Minus 100. Do you understand? This is minus 100. And now you observe if I am making a bigger and bigger, capital small a bigger and bigger, say for all practical purposes, if I make it two big number, 6 times this plus y is equal to, so this is 2 0 0 0 0 0 1. So for all practical purposes, this does not make any sense. So what is the equation, eventually what is the slope of this line now? Minus this much. Still it is not vertical, it is having negative slope. And now if this is a big number, if a is big number, and for all practical purposes coefficient of y becomes 0, then this is 2a, and therefore the equation of line will become x is equal to 2. That is our vertical line. Do you understand? I have just moved it in more than 90 degrees right now. So the dynamics here is, if you make, so now let me come to the conclusion part of it. It depends on ax plus by is equal to c, if a is big compared to b, if a is too big compared to b, then it becomes a vertical line. Do you understand? If a is too big compared to b, or for our practical purposes b is 0, then it is ax is equal to c, and therefore equation is x is equal to c by a, as b is equal to 0, then it is a vertical line and it is passing through c by a. X is equal to c by a comma 0. If a is too small and b is too big, then the equation becomes y is equal to c by b, because a is tending to 0. So y is equal to c by b. Then in that case, it is horizontal line and its y-axis intercept is 0 comma c by b. Right? And now the third situation. Okay. If we take the intercept of x-axis too long, the line becomes horizontal. If we take y-axis intercept too long, positive side, or too long, negative side, the y-axis intercept is too long, therefore line becomes parallel to y-axis. Now suppose if you remove this condition that it must pass through this point. If it is too long towards positive side, the line becomes parallel to x-axis. If it is too long to say intercept with y-axis at too long position, it becomes vertical. But we have kept the condition that it should pass through this point. Now suppose I remove it and say x-axis intercept also can be too long and y-axis intercept also can be too long. Do you understand what I am trying to do is, I am not keeping the point fix and the line has to pass through this. The dynamic situation is now that I am not putting it in front of me. I am saying let the line intersect y-axis at too long positive side, x-axis at too long positive side. Oh, too long positive side makes these people 0-0. So if both of them too long, then 0x plus 0y is equal to constant. And this constant need not be, this constant need not be 0. That is the situation. This constant need not be 0, and therefore we end up getting situation 0 is equal to 25. If you consider this equation to be true, and if I write LHS at 0x plus 0y is equal to 25, then yes, of course it is a line, and this line is called line at infinity. This is a line and it is called line at infinity. And by doing some more calculations, I can demonstrate you that algebraically that lines intersect. We said parallel lines intersect at infinity, but then all families of parallel lines intersect at corresponding infinities, and those points of intersections are collinear, and that is what is line at infinity. Okay, I am aware that it is beyond our visualization and you are too young to visualize this, but this is the beginning. This is where we want to break all the barriers and think loud. What happens? Because we started making these coefficients big or small in front of us, and we got lines parallel to x-axis and parallel to y-axis. So if we do the barrier of that fixed point 2, 1, and we take that point far away from origin, still those two lines will exist, still those lines will be existing, and correspondingly A also will become 0, B also will become 0 simultaneously, and we will end up getting equation of line looking like this. That is the way to imagine geometrically line at infinity, and many other times you end up getting algebraic equation something of this sort, which is perfectly all right. Algebra is saying the same thing which we are not capable of imagining. That is why we get some irregular results. But if we are understanding this properly, then nothing is irregular. Everything is happening as per plan. Algebra is properly giving us the answers. Okay, so coming back to what we were doing. U is parallel to y-axis, therefore b1 is not equal to 0. U is parallel to y-axis, therefore b1 is not equal to 0, and therefore U1 is not half. U1 is not parallel to y-axis. Okay, so now it is going to be easier for me to understand this statement. If U1 is not parallel to y-axis, B1 is not equal to 0. Otherwise also it was easy, because slope of this line was minus A1 by B1. And if it is not parallel to y-axis, B1 need not be 0. But now I think with this discussion, you will like understand it in a better way, or maybe I have confused you so much that even if I have explained you this way, you will not understand. So forget about this if you are confused, but otherwise U1 is not parallel to y-axis means B1 is not equal to 0. Okay, so let us complete the proof. So slope of U1 is equal to minus A1 upon B1. As U1 parallel u2, u2 is not parallel y-axis, implies b2 is also not equal to 0, implies minus a2 by b2 is slope of u. What we are supposed to show is where is our statement? Their slopes are equal. If possible, slopes are equal, which means a1 minus a1 upon b1 is equal to minus a2 upon b2. Therefore, we get a1 b2 is equal to a2 b1. And we should get some contradiction. Okay, let us search for contradiction. Now,
sir.
Yes.
So we are supposed to take if slopes are not equal, no?
Yes. If possible, slopes are not equal. If possible, slopes are not equal. So minus a1 upon b1 is not equal to minus a2 upon b2. That means a1 b2 is not equal to a2 b1. Correct. Okay. We should now find out for some contradiction. What is the point of intersection of these two lines? If possible, they are their slopes are not equal, then they will have point of intersection and both of them are not parallel to y. Point of intersection. Of u1 and u2 px0 y0 is equal to. Now I will directly write using Cramer's rule. It will be c1 b2 minus c2 minus c2 b1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1 comma a1 c2 minus a2 c1 upon a1 b2 minus a2 b1. This is the point of intersection. And as the denominator is not zero, as a1 b2 minus a2 b1 is not equal to zero, p x0 y0 is well defined. And therefore, u1 intersection u2 is not empty, which contradicts given statement u1 parallel u2. We have found out intersection point and therefore we have assumed something which is wrong. If possible, the slopes are not equal and therefore we have contradicted, hence slopes are equal, implies slopes are equal. Okay. Okay, so we have completed all the theoretical proof writing for all the assumptions that we had done while learning two dimensional geometry, and the results that were supposed to be proved, we had not proved at that time, and in last couple of lectures we have completed. Okay, now that is what is the content of 9th standard two dimensional geometry. Further in 11th standard we will learn 2D geometry much depth, where we will learn conic sections, circle also we have to learn a little bit in more detail, pair of lines, parabola, ellipse, hyperbola, we will learn it in 11th standard. So this is the last thing that we did in two dimensional geometry. Okay.